Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we went through the processes of conforming our EDL to DPX image sequences. Now we're going to add the leaders and check that the online conform matches the offline reference. Picking up from the previous video, I have now changed to the Timeline tab and switched to a source sequence view with option 2. Going to the leaders folder in the media library, I'll select the head leader and drag and drop it to the beginning of the sequence to overwrite the old segment. Make sure ripple is off. If ripple is not off, press option to temporarily toggle ripple, and you can also hold shift to enable or disable snap. Now navigate to the end of the sequence. With snap on, the default behavior is to snap the head of the clip to the positioner. Select the end header in the media library and drag that towards the sequence. In this case, I want to snap the tail of the clip to the positioner. Hold Ctrl, and now the tail of the clip will snap to the positioner. Overwrite the old tail leader, and now there should be no missing media in our sequence. Now let's do the continuity check with the offline reference movie. Hold Ctrl and don't release the keyboard shortcut until I tell you. Click the Version Plus button in the interface. In the pop-up menu, choose New and Mono Version. Choose this option and release the Ctrl button. The whole point for holding Ctrl is that it will insert a new version track below the online conform. Normally, a version track is inserted above the current edit, but I prefer to have my reference on the version track below. So that is the shortcut you can use. Now you can go to the offline folder and drag and drop the offline reference clip into the new version track at the same starting frame as the conformed sequence. Very good. Now switch to the single player view by pressing option 1. To compare the offline to the online, click on the empty square to enable the secondary version. Whichever version track you assign as the primary version will currently be viewed in the player. The online conform is assigned as the primary track, so that is what we're looking at. We can quickly switch between the primary and secondary views by clicking on these buttons or by using the F13 and F14 keyboard shortcuts. I'll now switch the primary to look at the offline version track. Now looking at the view, we have a small HD reference being compared to a 2K conform. To resize the offline reference to match, select the offline segment and change the resize setting to crop edges. This scales the HD offline to fit the 2K frame. So now you can go through the edit and flick between the version tracks to see that everything matches editorially. The one thing you will notice is that the colors don't match. The online color space is Red Log Film and the offline is Rec 709. This is typical for a digital intermediate conform. Editorial would have been using Rec 709 colored dailies appropriate for an Avid or FCP. But now we are using uncolored camera original material in log color space, which is what we want to go to when we color the material for final mastering. If you want the colors to be closer, we can adjust the color mapping of the offline. Although, this is simply for our own viewing pleasure and is not necessary. Select the offline segment in the sequence and click on the thumbnail in the effects bar. This will bring up the pre-processing settings and you can click Edit Pre-Processing. In this menu, you can choose the RGB LUT menu and set it to active. Change the conversion option from LIN to LOG. Press Exit and you return to the main sequence. The color will match up more or less, but as I mentioned before, they will never match perfectly. Now let's do a more accurate comparison. There are a few ways you can do this. Click on the Options pull-down menu to the right of the interface and choose the viewing settings. In the Viewing Settings menu, you will find a Compare setting. Change the pop-up menu from Primary Version to Difference. This operation does a mathematical difference between the primary and secondary version tracks. I will disable Clamp to improve the difference between the two and allow me to see whenever the two version tracks differ. If there is a difference, it will appear as white. The only difference here is the actual burn-in from the offline reference. Moving further down in the sequence, we will come across an area where there is a bigger difference. In this case, there is an image on an optical layer. In the last video, I mentioned that the optical layer would be shots that need special attention. In this case, a resize. You can place a marker by pressing M and come back to it later. You might also see differences in the image because of the color spaces, but it is not a major issue as long as things line up. So this is a pretty precise way to check continuity. The other option I like to use is a vertical split. Changing the compare option gives you a side-by-side comparison, and there are other split options you can choose from if you want. Please note that all of your editorial tools will work in these views. This includes trimming, slipping, and sliding to fix any issues or errors in the conform. Once you are done, you can switch the viewer back to primary only. And you can switch the viewing options off to get the most viewing space in the player. You can continue to use the primary, secondary, and view mode keyboard shortcuts to toggle the viewer. You can now start finishing your feature. This concludes the DI workflow and EDL conform. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoked Learning channel for future videos.